Our imagination may be the most brilliant of all energy that humans have ever possessed. Osamu Tezuka. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mildra, and I'll be your gaming monk for the evening. Let's talk about the idea of an anime tabletop RPG, which has taken an interesting turn since the early 2000s. Now, those of you who know me know that I've brought up the controversy of the Dungeons & Dragons expansion book, Tome of Battle, The Book of Nine Swords. The reason for this is the accusation of being too weeaboo that book had is a reflection of an attitude that many in the tabletop community had back then, and arguably some still do. That anime was this separate thing that required its own approach divorced from everything else. A close relative to this sentiment was the notion that you could only make something anime-styled if you were Japanese, which, given things I've talked about on Monastery Live, the more things don't change, I suppose. Now, this attitude has softened with time, in certain places, but there are still many games that treat anime itself as a genre instead of a medium. This week, we'll be delving into one of the more respective entries in this universal anime microgenre, Open Versatile Anime, or OVA. Created by Wise Turtle, OVA intends to be an accessible take on anime role-playing for people with a role-playing or anime background, or a background in neither. How does it hold up? Let's find out. OVA is a light read at 170 pages. There's no shortage of art in the book from Nico Geyer, and all of it is varied enough to demonstrate multiple genres. There's little parts of it that are hard to find. It's very well organized, and best of all, there's an index where it needs to be. To reference a certain series, all is right with the book, at least when it comes to layout. Character creation is rooted in a point-by-esque affair, and we'll be exploring this with a character named William Saika III, a demon-hunting gunslinger featured in a seinen campaign. That is what happens when I watch way too much Trigon and play Blood in the same sitting. The first step after concept is abilities, which are a list of abilities graded from +1 to +5. A +1 is considered average, while a +2 is considered good, +3 is masterful, +4 is incredible, and +5 is considered rare. It's advised that starting characters range from +1 to 2, with a few +3s and nothing higher than that. In our case, we'll be going with the following abilities. +1 in shooting attack, combat expert, intuitive, and spirit medium. A +2 in supernatural knowledge, evasive, and gear. And a +3 in his sunrise shot attack. The second step is weaknesses, obviously the mirror to abilities, and are graded from -1 to -3. -1 is a moderate flaw. -2 regularly affects the character, and -3 is near constant. Now, taking this into account, we'll have a -3 in Code of Conduct, Rival, and Wanted, and a -1 in Unlucky, Trigger, and Limited Uses. Some of these are tied to his Sunrise Shot ability, and others are tied to his pistol, Devilbane. The third step is Perks and Flaws, which mainly concerns attacks that we've purchased. The first reflects his basic attacks with Devilbane, his trusty revolver, and Sunrise Shot being a demon-killing bullet he has limited access to. The effects of both are represented through perks and or flaws that can modify the dice rolled, damage, and endurance cost. Devilbane, as an attack, only has the ranged and weapon modifiers, meaning it has no endurance cost. The latter, Sunrise Shot, adds ranged, weapon, accurate, limited uses, and effective, resulting in a total endurance cost of 15. Now, the final step is derived statistics, namely health, endurance, and defense. The default values for health and endurance is 40, which can be modified by certain abilities and or weaknesses. We don't have any of these that would apply here, so they default at 40. Defense starts at 2 and can be modified up or down based on abilities and weaknesses again. In this case, we do have something that applies. Specifically, the fact that we have a +2 in evasive, meaning our defense is 4. Character creation can be fast, but it's one where the point-by problem rears its head to a degree. By default, the game prefers that the sum of all your abilities and weaknesses is 0, but this can result in min-maxing. Beyond that, the sheer freedom the character creation entails is going to require more GM supervision than others. It's not a bad system, but it comes with caveats, and I think that sample templates would be a lot more useful here than sample characters. Open Versatile Anime uses a d6-based pool. When an action is called for, you roll 2d6, adding or subtracting dice based on abilities, weaknesses, or the GM's discretion, or any combination therein. You may keep either the highest die result or any dice sets that you roll. This total is compared to a difficulty number set by the GM to determine success or failure. While endurance is used as a fuel for special attacks like the Sunrise Shot, it can also be used as an extra effort to apply drama dice to a situation. A drama die is effectively another die that you roll outside of the ones that you would normally. Now, each die added costs 5 endurance points, but these points spent cannot be recovered via a short rest like they would normally. In terms of combat, rolls work largely the same, the only major difference being the presence of damage multipliers, since the amount of damage is based on the difference between attack and defense rolls. There are other complications such as the countering option, as well as combat approaches, but the majority of it is fairly simple. Now, this simplicity is nice and all, but in a way it veers close to the same problem that Cthulhu Tech had in being a bit swingy with the dice results. Now, this is not as bad due to having smaller dice pools, but I maintain that these sort of set-centric systems could do with a way to bank unused results and ensure the results aren't as wild. This is definitely one of the lighter reviews that I've done, but to be fair, OVA is a very light game. This is a broad sandbox, and it doesn't hide from that fact. Now, I'm not entirely sure how accessible it would be to those who have more of an anime-centric background, given how point-by systems can appear more intimidating than those that use some degree of archetypes and/or classes. Now, couple this with the fact that GMs are going to have to be more hands-on leads to potentially interesting situations. All that said, I'm willing to give the game a stamp of recommended. Now, if the game had a set of archetype examples rather than pre-generated characters, and more finely organized the abilities and weaknesses, I might have bumped this up to strongly recommended. OVA is very much a gateway drug of a game. It's not going to be the most complex, but it does provide an effective bag of Legos for the anime you want to make, so long as you're willing to freestyle.